Tonight on NewsWatch, voter fraud in a close election year. The tactics some are using to try and beat the system.
Plus, ending abortion in America, how Christians in the country are calling on God in the fight for life.
And hard hits in high school football. We'll look at the risks facing teenagers on the gridiron. All of this and more tonight on NewsWatch. And good evening, everyone. I'm Lee Webb.
And I'm Lori Johnson. Concerns about voter fraud are escalating as the election grows closer. Thousands of volunteers are mobilizing to look for signs of fraud on Election Day.
But several disturbing incidents have already been reported. Ephraim Graham has more.
Even before Election Day, voter fraud is an issue. Most problems so far have dealt with registration rules, early voting, and voter intimidation. The Virginia Attorney General is investigating alleged efforts to destroy voter registration applications statewide. Mysterious phone calls in Virginia and Florida have told voters they can vote by phone, which is not true. And fraudulent letters were sent out from Seattle to Florida voters, mainly targeting Republicans, telling them they may not be eligible to vote.
It says that there's a question on your eligibility to vote, and if you don't provide certain information and documentation within 15 days, you're going to be thrown off the rolls.
And a higher profile case of voter fraud. CBN's David Brody was among the first to report on a new undercover video. It captures Virginia Democrat Congressman Jim Moran's son and campaign field director discussing how to cast a ballot for someone else.
Yeah, I would look at the law, I would look at what you need, but I imagine it's going to be something, you know, it's just going to have name and address on there. It looks like you'll be able to satisfy that, but it's going to have to look legit.
The video is released by activist James O'Keefe, known for his voter fraud exposés. He set up the conversation by having a man ask about stealing votes. Patrick Moran resigned from his job with his father's campaign Wednesday night, releasing a statement that said, quote, "At no point did I take this person seriously. He struck me as crazy in retrospect. I should have just walked away," making it clear that there is no place in the electoral process for even the suggestion of illegal behavior.
He's resigned. That's going to go with him forever. He's done.
This is the age of fraud. Everything is fake nowadays, so this is really not surprising to me.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News.
Many states have passed laws designed to reduce voter fraud by requiring voters to present identification. Critics, though, say the laws intimidate voters and keep them from going to the polls. For more on the Virginia case involving the congressman's son and to see the entire undercover video, you can visit the Brody Files blog on cbnnews.com.
Wall Street Journal columnist and author John Fund says the U.S. has the sloppiest election system of any industrialized democracy. He's written a new book called Who's Counting? And he explained to us how easy it is to commit voter fraud.
First, there's absentee ballot fraud, which is, I think, the biggest. Absentee ballots are notoriously easy to coerce someone into voting a certain way. Absentee ballots are out there in the community. They can be mailed to apartment buildings under an alias and returned. There's all kinds of problems there. The second kind of problem that we have is what I call old-fashioned voter registration fraud, where you have so many names on the list, you can basically go in and if you don't ask for ID, anybody can get a ballot. And all you have to do is scribble some signature that resembles something that's on the rolls and you can vote. Eric Holder, the Attorney General of the United States, a 22-year-old volunteer working for James O'Keefe, the guy who did an acorn, walked into his Eric Holder's polling place in Washington in April, and he just said, "Do you have an Eric Holder on your voter list?" And he was handed his ballot. He didn't vote it, but that just shows how easy that kind of fraud can happen.
Fund added that ineligible voters like felons and illegal aliens who vote also add to the fraud problem.
A new poll shows Mitt Romney has wiped out President Obama's huge advantage among women voters. The Associated Press GFK poll shows Romney pulling even with Obama among women at 47-47. He had been trailing by 16 points just a month earlier. And on the central issue of the economy, Romney has pulled ahead among women voters. A month ago, women favored Obama over Romney on the economy 56% to 40%. Now the split has shifted to 49% for Romney, 45% for Obama. CBN News spoke with Penny Nance from the group Concerned Women for America.
Women have carried every presidential election since 1964. They want our vote. And, you know, clearly there's a range of ways the candidates are going after our vote. And again, I just address that the way that Barack Obama is trying to buy our vote with abortion and birth control. But it is essential that conservative Christian women vote. We are underrepresented at the polls on a normal year.
To view that entire interview with Penny Nance, you can go to our website at cbnnews.com.
Former Secretary of State Colin Powell says he's sticking with President Obama. The longtime Republican told CBS this morning that he will vote for the president for a second term. Powell says he agrees with Obama's economic performance and praised Mr. Obama for getting the country out of Iraq and keeping the United States from any new wars. Powell served as Secretary of State under George W. Bush and says he's still a Republican.
Pro-life organizations play different roles in the effort to end abortion in our country. One group is committed to praying and standing vigil outside abortion clinics. Paul Strand reports on 40 Days for Life outside the second largest Planned Parenthood clinic in the country.
Those who gather at 40 Days for Life vigils, like this one in Denver, Colorado, spend most of the time praying.
It gives you an actual concentrated, dedicated way to come and pray.
But every once in a while, you'll hear a heartbreaking story, like the one a young man told Annette Bryce at a vigil.
He said, "My girlfriend had an abortion because she said I couldn't marry her because I didn't have a job." And I said, I told her that I would still find a way and support her and save the baby. And she had an abortion. The next day, I got a job.
I've had three abortions.
Some here are trying to save women from making the same mistake they did in aborting their own children.
Women are naturally nurturing mothers, and there's always that hole when you've aborted a child or terminated a pregnancy. You know, you could live for years and deny it and think that, oh, I, you know, and try to bury it and go through your life and do normal things and live a pretty normal life, but it's always very deep-seated, deep down where you never get over it.
But then you hear sweet stories of success, like what happened with a woman in Monsignor Bernard Schmidt's own parish.
She was considering an abortion. She heard a prayer for an end to abortion and for protection of human life and decided not to go abort the child.
One such change of heart sticks in Rosalinda Lozano's memory, involving a woman who was secretly pregnant and had told no one she was getting an abortion.
Sunday night, her mother called her and said, "Angelica, please, do not do anything to that baby." She said, "I have prayed to our Lord, and when you get to that clinic," which she had never told her mother she was coming, "when you get to that clinic, you will see people praying for you, and those people were sent by God." And she said, "When I came around the corner on Monday, I saw you kneeling down and praying."
Angelica had her baby. Such stories keep many of these prayer warriors coming back.
I feel like it gives the women hope when they see us out here praying, when they know that we're here giving of our time for them. I think it makes a difference.
It's enormous. You know, there's no judiciary or police force that can stop a prayer.
Bob Gilson from nearby Boulder says if believers knew the effects their prayers could have, many more would be out at the 40 Days for Life vigils nearest them.
There are babies' lives being lost. There are women suffering from it. There are people who have had abortions, lose relationships, or have trouble with substance abuse, or suicides. The list goes on and on.
There's still plenty of time left for those who want to join in. This 40 Days campaign goes through the Sunday just before Election Day.
This is the 11th campaign for 40 Days for Life. Has it had an effect? Well, during these vigils, some 6,000 babies have been saved, about 70 abortion workers have quit their jobs, and a couple of dozen abortion facilities have closed down. Paul Strand, CBN News, reporting from the 40 Days for Life vigil in Denver.
In France, supporters of traditional marriage protested the government's push to legalize gay marriage and give homosexual couples the right to adopt. Hundreds came out to speak for values in Paris this week. Those posters say, "A father, a mother, we don't lie to children."
We are against this law in the name of the rights of the children, because we want to protect the children against a very unfair privation, the one of a daddy or a mommy. It is necessary to help the families who have problems, single parents, children who need support. But it seems to us unfair to deliberately decide that a child won't have a father or a mother.
The bill is set to be introduced to the parliament on November 7th.
Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu's political party may have more support from hardline voters in the upcoming parliamentary elections in Israel. Netanyahu's Likud party will join forces with the party of his ultra-nationalist foreign minister for the election. Israeli media speculate the move is meant to slow the momentum of the growing Labor Party.
The father of that Pakistani girl shot by the Taliban is speaking out for the first time since the attack. Malala Yousafzai's dad is promising the 15-year-old girl will return to Pakistan after she's recovered from the shooting. That despite the continuing threat of Taliban violence against the girl. Yousafzai was shot earlier this month after speaking out against the terrorist group and for advocating for women's education. She's currently recovering at a hospital in Britain.
The man accused of shooting a security guard inside the Family Research Council headquarters building now faces a terrorism charge. Floyd Lee Corkins is the first person in 10 years to be prosecuted under the District of Columbia's Anti-Terrorism Act. Police arrested Corkins back in August. He's accused of opening fire inside the lobby of the FRC's downtown Washington building. Investigators say he was carrying a backpack full of ammunition and Chick-fil-A sandwiches. The incident happened right after Chick-fil-A's president, Dan Cathy, made headlines by standing up for traditional marriage. The controversy surrounding Chick-fil-A's stand has done nothing to hurt its business. In fact, it may have helped. The fast food chain saw a 2.2% increase in customer traffic at a time when gay activists were calling for boycotts. The third quarter figures are based on a Sandelman and Associates survey of more than 30,000 Chick-fil-A consumers. The numbers have left some experts scratching their heads.
The Obama administration is responding to new emails that raise questions about when it knew the Libya consulate attack was terrorism. On Tuesday, news outlets reported that just hours into the assault, the State Department sent emails stating that a militant Islamic group was on Facebook taking credit for the attack. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton says emphasis shouldn't be put on just one document.
You know, posting something on Facebook is not, in and of itself, evidence. And I think it just underscores how fluid the reporting was at the time and continued for some time to be.
Members of the House and Senate Intelligence Committees have expressed frustration with conflicting reports about what happened.
Coming up, heavy rain from Hurricane Sandy. The storm has made landfall. We'll show you where it is and where it may be headed.
It's probably something I've had for many years, and every year the PSA would be a little higher. I just kept kind of ignoring it. You know, one of those guy things. It'll go away. It'll go away. Finally, one day, Janet says, "You're going to the doctor." They did a blood test. My PSA was 14. I needed to get a second opinion, so we contacted Cancer Treatment Centers of America.
To find out more about Cancer Treatment Centers of America and our unique treatment options for complex and advanced stage cancer, go to cancercenter.com.
The really great thing is that you just go online, and if you have prostate or lung cancer or whatever, you can see what their survival rates are.
You can also check for participating insurance plans. Cancer Treatment Centers of America is different. You feel it the moment you call or walk into one of our hospitals. It's state-of-the-art medicine, unique treatment options, and a level of compassion that cannot be copied. Why? Our people. People who give you not only their expertise, but their humanity. And the most thoughtful, well-organized, patient-centered care you'll find anywhere.
Cancer Treatment Centers of America go way beyond what normal hospitals do. I knew that they had the technology to take care of my cancer. It's a device called Calypso.
Calypso is GPS for the prostate. We're able to get four-dimensional, real-time tracking of prostate movement during radiation treatment.
It eliminates a lot of my side effects. It makes sense. It just makes sense. I own a deli. I'm back at work. My customers come in and say, gosh, you look good. And some of them say I look better now than I did before I left. I didn't expect to learn a lesson about how to treat people by being in a hospital. You can tell when somebody really cares.
Every minute counts when you're fighting complex or advanced stage cancer. So please call or visit cancercenter.com today. Appointments are available now. Cancer Treatment Centers of America. Care that never quits.
Hurricane Sandy made landfall today in southern Cuba as a Category 2 storm. Forecasters say Sandy could twist and hit the East Coast early next week with strong winds, flooding, heavy rain, and possibly snow. The hurricane is expected to collide with an early winter storm from the west and a blast of Arctic air from the north, creating a so-called perfect storm. Sandy has already claimed two lives in the Caribbean.
Hard to believe we're dealing with a hurricane this late in the season. But CBN's Operation Blessing is taking steps now to prevent another cholera outbreak from spreading in Haiti in the wake of this hurricane. Water supplies will take a hard hit due to Sandy's flooding rains. OB is working around the clock to produce chlorine to help purify those supplies. Water purification in Haiti has been a major focus of Operation Blessing since the 2010 earthquake devastated that country. Haiti is currently home to the world's largest cholera epidemic. In the last 2 years, more than 7,000 people have died from the disease.
Here at home, that meningitis outbreak is now being blamed for 24 deaths and more than 315 people are sick. The outbreak is being linked to tainted steroid shots from a Massachusetts pharmacy. Now the governor of Massachusetts says the state is taking steps to make sure another outbreak does not occur.
The pharmacy board will immediately start periodic, unannounced inspections of compounding pharmacies that prepare sterile, injectable medications, such as those directly linked to the outbreak. These pharmacies will be inspected at least annually and more frequently in the case of a substantiated complaint.
The New England Compounding Center is the pharmacy that made the tainted steroid used to treat back pain. The Food and Drug Administration does not apply very strict regulations to compounding pharmacies.
Up next, the concern over concussions, why some are calling for an end to an American pastime, high school football.
Listen up for an amazing offer that can change the way you hear.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you. Can you repeat that?
Frustrated with your hearing?
What did he say?
Well, hear better now. Introducing the fully rechargeable MSA30X, a revolutionary device that features the latest microsound amplification technology that can barely be seen. Independently tested to help you hear up to 30 times better. It turns ordinary hearing into extraordinary hearing. MSA30X works by capturing and amplifying sound waves, yet its lightweight ergoacoustic design is discreet. It form fits in and around either ear.
I forget I'm even wearing it.
An MSA30X is powerful. Hear clearly in restaurants. Never miss another word on TV or at the movies.
My wife complains that I have the volume up on the TV too loud.
And I didn't want to be in the same room with them.
Now I can hear everything clearly.
Simply adjust the volume as you desire. Other units use so many batteries and they're difficult to change. But the MSA30X is completely rechargeable. Simply plug it into the wall.
I tried other devices that had batteries, but they were always such a pain to change and so costly. But this is rechargeable, so I figure I save hundreds a year.
Bulky sound amplifiers can cost hundreds, but try MSA30X for just $59.95 and we'll include a cleaning brush and 5 comfort tips. But wait. In this special TV offer, we'll cut the price in half. Now you can hear up to 30 times better for just $29.95. But there's even more. We'll double the offer free. Just pay additional processing and handling. Wear them both or give one to a loved one. Did you hear that? That's two MSA30Xs for just $29.95. The MSA30X Hear Better Now offer. Get two for just $29.95.
All I can say is just try it. It could change your life.
To order the MSA30X sound amplifier, call 1-800-535-0654. That's 1-800-535-0654. Or you can go to msa30x.com. Call or go online now.
The future of a football program at a New Hampshire high school could be in jeopardy. A school board member is on a mission to ban the sport. Retired Dr. Paul Butler played high school football himself, but he says the sport is just too dangerous.
that uses the head as a battering ram is not a smart game to allow a youngster to play.
Butler admits he does not have enough votes to pass the ban on high school football, but he says this is just the first step towards the inevitable. And one reason the proposed ban does not have as much support is people may not realize how violent the game of football really is.
Well, even at the high school level, players are constantly injured, oftentimes receiving concussions. Here's more.
Bob in trouble, gets rid of it. Oh, big hit.
Big hits are one of the reasons we watch football.
And there is a penalty marker.
But they can also be dangerous. According to the watchdog website, theconcussionblog.com, the NFL had 159 concussions last season and handed out several five-figure fines for helmet-to-helmet hits. But the issue is not isolated to pro athletes.
Oh, what a great open field hit by Eric LeGrand.
Rutgers defensive tackle Eric LeGrand was paralyzed from the neck down last season after this tackle on a kick return. At the high school level, Greenbrier Christian Academy in Chesapeake, Virginia, had several players suffer concussions last year, including senior quarterback Nicholas Jesse.
He came off the end and hit me pretty hard.
You know, he got his bell rung good.
The next series on offense, we were going to punt. I was like blanking out, and then I went to go get the ball after it went past me. And like the ball, it felt like it was rolling around, but it was just sitting there.
I just saw he just didn't respond back, didn't get back in his back pedal like he should. And then we pulled him out, come to the sideline. I'm talking to him, he's not responsive to me.
Senior linebacker Austin Pyatt was not even aware he had a concussion until an official told him to leave the game.
I'm running to the other side of the field, and I grab the guy, and when I spin around, our safety comes through, and I catch his knee to my chin.
It was a normal play. It wasn't a big crushing hit.
I just remember, like, I blacked out, basically. And first thought was, that's not good. And then I was like, we need to finish this game out. So I didn't want to come out, but I guess it's safety. It's my brain.
An effort to teach head safety to an even younger age group has affected the way video games are being designed. The latest version of EA Sports Madden NFL will no longer allow helmet-to-helmet hits, head-first tackles, and will require players to sit out for the entire remainder of any game in which they sustain a concussion.
Getting real, very realistic. I think that's good.
That's something as a coach you have to deal with. When you got a player who gets suspected of concussion, he sits.
If you get a concussion in real life, you're gonna get taken out the rest of the game.
The average impacts are in the 15 to 20 Gs. So that's 15 to 20 times the acceleration of gravity. As you look at the higher end, we'll have 80, 90, 100 G, 120, even 150 G impacts that the players can sustain within the course of a season.
Dr. Stefan Duma has been conducting impact research at Virginia Tech for more than 8 years, accumulating data on over 1 million head impacts.
We began this research project in 2003, and that was the first time in the world anyone had done that for football players.
Duma's research moved from the field to the lab, where he and his team tested every major manufactured football helmet on the market last year. Their findings have been published as a comprehensive star ranking system on the school's website.
Before it was all cost and appearance, and now you have some idea of the biomechanical response.
I got the new Rydell Speed that was supposed to have a lot more padding.
But Jesse's coaches believe equipment is only part of the prevention solution.
I don't think that there's one helmet that can prevent a concussion.
We're constantly telling our kids, head up, and we call them duckers, and we get a duckers, we won't let them go.
A lot of kids, they want to come in and make the big blow and hit and just, you know, kind of not wrap up and just throw their body around. But with proper technique, you will prevent injury.
The desire to see and deliver big hits in football may not change, but the outcome for those involved at every level of the sport is the same.
The goal is for everybody to play, have fun, and then get out of the game safe.
That's fascinating. Lori, you're the mother of an outstanding high school football player who's probably going to go on to play in college.
Yes.
Are you concerned about his well-being?
I was concerned about his well-being. He is a lineman, and he's about 285 pounds, 6'4".
Yeah.
And when I expressed my concern to him, he said, "Mom, you need to worry about the people I'm hitting, not me." And that's actually true, because some of these games in which I've been watching him, he has injured some of the other players, and they've been on the field for a while.
But he's not sustained any serious injuries?
Not yet, but I've been praying pretty hard for some of the kids that he's hit.
That's exciting. All right, well, thanks very much, and we'll be right back after this.
My feet hurt, your feet hurt. White hot pain, I wanna cry. Is there anything I can try?
Why, yes. Introducing Strut Soul Angels, the human shock absorber that helps alleviate foot pain.
The first 10 steps in the morning to the bathroom were excruciating. Within 3 days after I put Struts on, it's been such a relief.
Slipped it on and almost immediately I felt a support, kind of like a pillow underneath my arches.
The Struts Soul Angel provides a great amount of relief and support throughout the course of the day, providing shock absorption and relief of pain.
On your feet without proper support can be painful. Struts Soul Angels promotes better balance, control, and body alignment. Standing in your heels all day is painful, but slip on Struts and you'll enjoy comfort and support 24/7. Struts is so versatile, you'll wear them in every shoe you own, even barefoot.
I'm on my feet all the time. I teach 11 and 12 year olds. The pain was so much that I knew I had to do something. And with the Struts, I can do my job and enjoy my job.
I usually am on my feet from 8 to 12 hours a day. When I wear my Struts, it's like giving my feet a hug all day.
It's life changing. I wear them from the minute I get up to the minute I go to bed.
Why pay $400 for custom orthotics?
Now get Strut Soul Angels for just $10. You also get Miracle Foot Repair Cream, absolutely free. Use it to help relieve dry, callous feet overnight. But wait, call right now and we'll double the offer free. Just pay separate processing and handling. Plus, you get a 100% money-back guarantee. If not completely delighted, send it back. But keep the foot cream as our gift just for trying. You get it all, a $70 value for just $10.
Oh, yes! Love my Struts, the best thing since sliced bread. They heal pain from toes to head. Get yours now, your doctor said.
Struts, be nice to your feet. Call now.
Call 1-800-787-1580 and get your Struts and Miracle Foot Repair for just $10 and we'll double the offer. That's 1-800-787-1580 or visit GetStruts.com.
Finally tonight, some well-known superheroes were on hand to surprise hundreds of sick children in Tennessee.
They took to the sky to lift the spirit of patients at Le Bonheur Children's Hospital. Kids, parents, and staff alike surrounded the windows trying to get a peek as a show of three men twisted and somersaulted down the walls of the 12-story building. The men are part of the hospital's window cleaning company. They decided to dress up as Spider-Man and Captain America to entertain the kids inside. They say it's a chance to grant the wish of so many of the young patients. The men say they hope the four-hour show, complete with silly string, distracts the kids from their surroundings, even if for just a minute.
What a great idea, and I'm sure those guys had a lot of fun doing that.
Yeah, God bless them. What a great service. Well, that's all the time we have for this edition of NewsWatch.
Remember, you can email us your comments and questions at newswatch@cbn.com, and we hope you'll join us next time.
Have a good evening, everyone.